And welcome back to your science class. In today's class, we are going to understand the process of getting wool from the fiber. Okay, this is the most important topic of this chapter. We have already understood that from where do we get the wool. There are many animals like sheep, goats, rabbits, alpaca, llamas, yak, camel that provides us wool. In today's class, we are going to understand that how we get the fabric out of the hair that we get from the sheep. So the woolen clothes, the blanket, the shawls that you wear, they are the final product of the long process. Okay, there is a long process and there are many steps which are involved which result in giving you the final product that you use, that you wear in winter clothes, in winter season. Let's understand what are the various steps. As you can see here, there are many steps, okay? So that is, the first one is shearing, then comes scouring, then comes sorting, then comes removal of burrs, then there is sorting. After sorting, there is removal of burrs, dyeing, combing, and then finally, we get the yarn. We will study these process in details one by one. So as soon as we remove the hair from the skin of any sheep or any animal, the process starts from there only, and that removal of hair from the sheep is known as shearing. Okay, so what is shearing? Let's see here. So if you can see here, you will notice that this is a sheep, okay, and there is one tool which is very similar to the tool which is used by the barber. Okay, so when you go for a haircut, the barber also uses a tool to remove the hair from your skin. Similarly, the fleece or the hair of sheep, along with a thin layer of skin, is removed from its body. This process is called as shearing, as you can see in the picture also. But this process does not harm the sheep. It does not harm the sheep as it doesn't harm you when you go for a haircut to a barber. Yes, when you go for a haircut, you are also not harmed. Similarly, they are also not being harmed in this process. And generally, their hair are being removed in the winter season, in summer season, sorry. So their hair is being removed in summer season so as they can survive without their coating, because we all know that this fleece or that hair, it prevents them from the harsh climate. But in summer, they don't need this warm layer of hair. So it is removed generally in summer season, and the hair or the fleece grows back again in the same way as your hair grows after you get a haircut. So this is a process which doesn't harm the sheep, okay? So this process is known as shearing, and shearing is generally done in summer season by using a tool which is very similar to the tool which is used by barber when you go for a haircut. And once the shearing process is done, again after a few months, the hair of the sheep comes back again. So this is the first process, or we can say the beginning of going towards making of fabric. So the first one is shearing. Now after shearing comes the another process which is known as scouring. So the children, the sheared skin, okay, the skin from the sheep is thoroughly washed in tanks to remove the grease, dust and dirt. Okay, so if you will see the hair that we get from the sheep, it has so much of dirt, okay, so much of grass, because sheep are all over the grass. They eat grass, they are herbivorous, they are full of dirt, they also have grease in them. So we need to remove it first, okay? So this process is known as scouring, S-C-O-U-R-I-N-G. This process is known as scouring, and for that we use detergents, okay? We use detergent and other chemicals to get rid of these dirt, grease and grass. Generally, this process is also being done in factories. As you can see here, these are the long big tanks in which the scouring process is done. Also, at small amount, if the scouring is being done in small little amount, then it can be easily done at home also. We just have to take the hair or the fleece from the sheep, and we can easily clean it by using detergent. So this is the second process which is known as scouring. Now after scouring, we need to sort, okay, because as I told you earlier that sheep has two type of hairs, okay, they have two type of hairs. One is coarse beard hair and the okay? So we need to sort them, okay? Different sheep have different color of hair in them. Some are of black in color. Some breed of sheep possess black hair on their skin. Some possess white skin on their body. Some possess soft hair. Some possess rough hair. So we need to separate them, okay? So that is the process of sorting. So after scouring, once the scouring is done, we dry the hair and then we do the sorting. So workers are assigned for sorting. Okay, they sort the hair of the hair from the sheep on the basis of their color, on the basis of their quality, on the basis of their weight, and so on. So this is the process of sorting, and this is very important because accordingly we can make woolen clothes out of it. So hair of different textures are separated. Next is, here you can see this man is doing the sorting. He has these blue bins in which he is putting the different textures and different colors of hair. Now the next one is removal of buds. Now children, if you can also recall this situation when you wear clothes, okay, when you wear any woolen clothes like sweater or blanket, you must have noticed that a small knot of cloth, okay, that is burrs. Okay, and we remove it by our hands. Remember, can you recall it? So that is burr. Okay, so similarly, those burrs are also removed from the sorted fleece or the sorted hair. As you can see here, this man is removing the burrs. Any unwanted thing, you can say any small insect or some unwanted hair, that is what we call as removal of burrs. These are the same burrs which sometimes appear on your sweater. Okay, so the fibers are scored again and dried. This is the wool ready to be drawn into wire. So after removal of burrs, it is again scored. Scored means scoring. Scoring means the cleaning of fiber. Okay, so after sorting, the fiber is again clean. Okay, next is dyeing. Okay, so now after we have sheared this hair, we have done the cleaning, we have done with the sorting, we have sorted the different types of hair, we have sorted or we have separated different colors hair, different colors of textures and different colors, different textures, different feet. Okay, we have done the sorting. After sorting, there comes dyeing. Okay, so after that, we dye the hair in the different colors. Here you can see there is this liquid and they dip the hair, you can see the wool in that color, and we get the desirable color. After that, they are combed, they are straightened, because the hair that we get from the sheep is not straight, okay, or any animal, they are not straight. So they are being combed, they are being straightened, and they are then spun into these yarns. As you can see here, I have got this small, I don't know if you can see, this is what we call as yarn, and this is the fiber. Okay, this black thread that you can see here is fiber. This is the cotton fiber actually. Okay, so this is how they are knitted into fiber, and after that we knit it. Okay, so we knit it, and then these yarns are then converted into sweaters and other woolen clothes. So this is the journey of fiber into any fabric. So the processing of fibers into wool is done in 6 steps. So the number one is shearing. What is shearing? The fleece of the sheep is removed from its body along with a thin layer of the skin by using machines. It's called as shearing. Next one is scouring. The sheared skin with hair is washed in tanks to remove grease, dust, and dirt. This process is called as scouring. Second process. Next is, the hairy skin is sent to a factory where hairs of different textures, different colors are separated. This is known as what? This is known as sorting. Next, the small fluffy fibers called burrs. This is the same fiber that you sometimes find in your sweater. That is small fluffy fibers. Okay, that is different from the fiber which is used for making your clothes. Okay, they generally comes out of it. So they are called burrs. So these burrs are separated from the hairs and again washed and dried. So this is separate. separation of buds. Next process, the fibers are then dyed. So the next step is dyeing. Next is the fibers are then straightened and corn. This is the last process. Then it is converted into yarns like this, and that yarn is then used for making clothes by weaving or by knitting. So I hope children you have understood this journey of hair from the sheep or from animal to the woolen clothes. So all the woolen clothes that you wear, they are coming out from the animals, whether it's a goat, any or sheep, camel, alpaca, anything. So okay, so these are the various steps which are involved in making the sweaters that you wear. It's a long process, and the sweater that you wear is a finished product of it. We will take this class forward. Till then, take care.